Hello, welcome. This is Berdy. Welcome to a new lesson in Houdini. Today we'll start a new series, Missile Trail with Pyro in Houdini. Today we'll learn how to emit a missile from a plane in Houdini and use a pop network for this emit. So let's get started. So let's start it, guys. Bismillah. First I will save the file inside a project I already did in previous projects. Okay, so I will simply just save as, and as I will save it here. So I already save it as cargo plane English. Okay, so if it's your first time, simply make a new project, save it the folder. Then save the file inside the folder you just did. Okay, I already explained this before. So by this we will save all the caching and rendering in one folder. Okay, it's better organized. So let's get started. First I will hit file. I will import the 3D model for a plane that I downloaded from the internet from Free3D. Okay, in this file you will find, in this website you will find lots and lots of 3D modeling, even saving by different file format like C4D for Cinema 4D. So you will find the whole scene by its light and camera and shader and everything. Okay, Maya 3D, FBX, and blah blah blah, Blender, I think. Yeah, Blender. So I think you will find it here at aircraft. So you can download any free plane. Okay, it's easy to find the plane that I downloaded. I think it's in 4 or 5, something like this. Okay. So now let's import the aircraft. This is the aircraft, it's called cargo plane. So I hit accept. Of course I would like to say that this is the first series or project for missile trail in Houdini. Okay, we will use the smoke trail in the shelf tool, but I will make after this project another project, but with advanced, more advanced techniques. Okay, so this will be simple techniques, and the other one will be more advanced technique. Okay, so I think this plane need to scale. Okay, so I think it need to be minus 90 X. I want it to go in the X in the Z direction, not in the X direction. So I think I will make it no. Yeah. Yeah, so now it's going in the Z direction, which is right for the viewport, that for the viewport coordinates. Okay, but you can make it going in the X direction, doesn't really matter. Second, we need to scale it, because if we see its boundary box, it's like 280 meter width, 80 height. Tall 180, so it's huge. So maybe I will make it 0.05. Hit F to frame it. Yeah, so this is a reasonable size, 13 meter by 8 meter. Of course, it should be bigger than this. You can make it bigger as a real plane. Okay. It's up to you. So this is for second. We need a plane to go forward, as if it's flying or moving, right? So we'll make another transform. I like things to be organized, so every transform make something. So this for rotation and the scale, and this for transform. Okay. So I think it will go forward to in the F, in the Z direction. So I will hit dollar sign F capital, meaning frame, every frame I will have every frame. So basically it's going 1 meter every frame, so 24 per meter per second, mean 24, it's flying 24 per meter per second. So calculator, let's see, 24 meter per second times 60, so it's flying 1 kilo and 44 meter in 1 minute. It's flying like 1 kilometer by 60 hour. Oh, it's very, very fast. Its speed 86,000. Okay, I'm not sure if this makes sense or not, if plan going this, but anyway, you can know. Okay, so this is not important, but just you can know in this infographic every plane and its maximum speed. Boeing 777, it's like average speed almost 1K, meaning 1000. So it's 9100, like 1000 kilometer, 1000, like I think this is almost 1 million, because this K is meaning, yeah. Okay, so I think this is not bad, but maybe it can be more faster, but anyway, doesn't really matter. So let's continue. Now we need to we need the fan, the fans to rotate, right? So I need to separate it. So let's go here to, I think, yeah. Connected, yes, it's 3D connect. So I will connect those and hit blast. Oh, forget one. Yeah, I'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Blast. Okay, so delete and select, we have it here. Also I need to select this one, so let's connect this one. Blast, make sure to type blast here, not here. Okay, but boss, I will change it, I will connect it to the source. Okay, so we have the left and right. Okay, and last I need this one also to be blast, but the airplane only. Or you know what, I think if I take this to control C, control V, delete non select, delete non select, That's weird. Anyway, this is left, this is right. Not sure which why it's doing, but anyway, I will do it just simply by select them all again. I'll hit blast. Yeah, but make sure to reconnect them here and here. Okay, so we have the plane, we have the first fan and the second fan. Perfect. Okay, so let's make a transform, of course. Let's see which first I need to make the pivot point in the center, because as we can see here, if I try to rotate it, its center is here, so it will rotate around the pivot point here, so it will not make any sense. Okay. So I need to make the I need to make the center, the pivot point in the center here. How can we do that? I think pivot transform, if we type CEX, I think we should type dollar sign, not sure, yeah, dollar sign CEX, type dollar sign CEY, capital, hit type. Dollar sign, control C, control V, dollar sign C, E, Z. So as we can see here now, the pivot point in the center itself. So when it will rotate, it will rotate in the right direction. So just, we need, yeah, this one. So I think it will be like dollar sign F multiply by 100. So every second it will rotate 100 time per second. Okay, I will control C, control V. Yeah, this is the other fan. I will connect it, but maybe I will multiply by 1 multiply by 1.1, maybe something like this. Okay. So it will be a little different than this number, right? It will be faster, but it doesn't really matter. It will be a little faster. We can make it even 05, something like this. So it will be a little, yeah, perfect. Okay, so now let's merge them back again. Here is the one, here is the two, here is the three amigos. So let's check them one last time. As we can see here, they are rotating. I don't want to see this anymore. Yeah. So as we can see now, it's flying. Okay. So now we have the airplane. We're not going to do anything else, I think, about this airplane. We don't need it. Just maybe I will make a null just for organization, and type this out, aircraft. So this will be the out aircraft. Okay, it will be rendered, but we're not going to use any of this in the simulation itself. Okay, so this first step. Second step, okay, let us also type it here, aircraft. So second thing, okay, so file crashed. I'm not sure why, but it happened. I didn't save it. Always make sure to save it. I'm not sure if there is an auto saving here in Houdini or not, but I will try to search about it to see if there is auto save. So it will save every maybe 5 minutes or 10 minutes a backup or something like this. It will be much very helpful. Okay, someone remind me of this. Okay, anyway, so now let's make the let's make the missile going out from the plane. Okay, so I will make another geometry. I will call this emitter. Get inside, maybe go to other object just to see where is the plane for. So of course this is a cargo plane, but let's say it's war plane, so or just someone put it a weapon inside it. Okay, so let's make an add node. The plane is here and the add is here. First I need to make the point itself, then I will move it. So I'm moving like this, maybe like this, to see where I will put it. Maybe something like this is in the center. Space 3. I'll put it here. Let's see if I put it here, what's going to happen. Space 1. Yeah. Space 4, so let's move it. Yeah, it will be maybe here. You can put it here, you can put it here, any place. You know what, I will put it here. Maybe I'll put it just here. Okay, so now the point in its place, new place, new transform. So now we need to move the transform, so the point. So I will add transform transform not sure why. You know what, I think I will put the transform here. It will move it in the direction that I want. Yeah, here it is, but I'm not sure why. What is this for? Okay, anyway, something weird. Let's make a sphere just to make sure where exactly. Copy to point. We will use the copy to point anyway. Yeah, so it's in the right place. It was just an illusion, but as we can see here, it's in the right place. Okay, let's continue. Now we need points. Still give me the point here, but anyway, not sure why. Anyway, so I will put simply the same speed in the Z, dollar sign F. So the point will move forward, as we can see here, with the airplane, synchronized with the airplane. Okay. Now I need to make a here is the point. It's becoming a little weird. Okay, I wasn't sure what was the problem, but I think everything now is fine. Okay, so now I need a normal in two directions, this direction and the opposite direction. So when we emit particle from pop network and inherit this velocity, okay, after we convert the normal to a velocity, so we will have the point going in this way or the other way. Okay, we will make two nodes. So let's start it. First, I need to make create a normal. So I will make simply a point. Okay, I will make it in different way. The normal, and also I need a constant value. I will make it 1 in x direction. So if I type the normal here, as we can see, yeah, it's in this direction. As we can see here, yeah, normal is in this direction. So I want to opposite. So I can copy and paste and minus 1. You know what, I will do this, just simply copy and paste and minus 1. So it will be in the opposite direction, but of course there are many ways to make normal, by Wrangler, by VOP, any, by create a parameter. There are lots and ways. Okay, next we need to attribute rename. I don't need the normal anymore, so I will just simply type n here and velocity here, v small, n capital. So now we have a trail instead of normal. As we can see here, this is the direction, and control c control v, and this is the other direction. So we have both direction. Okay, now let's make a pop network. Let's put maybe put first one here and second one here, doesn't matter which in which, but just in the first handle and second handle. So let's get here. I don't need to see the velocity anymore. Yeah. So now let's continue. Let's get inside here. First, I need to let's see what we have so far. We have the, as you can see, the particle. If I hide the, you cannot see much because we are scattering on the surface. I will type all points. So every frame it will emit one particle, because we only have one particle. We can control how many particles to emit every frame if we type a code here. So maybe I can type dollar sign F module 2 minus equal 0. This mean every 2 frame give me one. It will be 0. Okay, so that means it will be every 2 frame it will be 1 then 0, as we can see here 0 1 0 1 0 1. So it will emit a point every 2 frame, right? And also another thing to happen is if frame frame small than maybe 40, yeah, that's it. So it will emit every 2 frame and it will stop emitting in frame after frame 40. As we can see here now, all it's become 0 0 0 0. Okay, perfect. We can make it 3, we can make it 4, really it's up to you. Make it 3 just to make a space. Okay, so this is the first thing. Second, we need to add, let's see, maybe we can inherit the scale of the velocity, multiply by 20. So it, as we can see here, it will move very very fast, very away from the airplane. But it's going in the right and not going not full, and of course gravity should take a place, right? So we can add force or gravity force, gravity, yeah, here is gravity force. So now all the particle will, as we can see here, they will simply follow after frame 40, right? Yeah, make it 30, and of course you can add add inherit velocity, change it via variable, maybe something like this. Maybe we can make it something like this to give it more randomization, right? And also you can add I think bob point, and also bob force will work. I think both are almost the same, except bob point has a drag force, air resistant, but force doesn't have. I think this is a difference. So I will add a little more drag force, like 0.1. I will add amplitude 2, maybe 5. Let's see. Yeah, it looks much better. And also the swirl size, I'll make it maybe 10. Make the swirl size is big. Okay, perfect. So last but not least, let's copy this, control C, control V, make it like this. Also add it here, but this time instead of using a first context, use the second context. So it will simply, as we can see here, it move in the other direction, and of course we can make some seed. Maybe I will make it pairs of, no, not 1 second, I will make it, leave it as 100, doesn't matter. But maybe add some variants like this. And also here maybe we can add maybe something like this. So there will be a little different between, yeah, as we can see here. Okay, perfect. We have the emitter now. Now we can emit. We have the velocity in this. Yeah, looks really nice. Yeah, okay. Okay, so now we can make the smoke trail. Okay, but first let's make this null and type this out, emitter. Yeah, and control S to save it. So we need to also there are two ways now to continue to make a trail as a line from every particle, or simply just make a sphere and then use a trail, smoke trail. Okay, so I think I will use the easy way this time. Okay, so I will use just simply smoke trail. But first we have to make a sphere. Okay, make a copy to points. Yeah, no, here. Yeah, so the plane, as we can see, it emit sphere, but of course this sphere is very big. We need to change it. We can change it like this, but all it will be same size, but maybe we can play with the size a little bit to make randomization. So there are two ways to make it, by attribute randomize, or simply type a code in the attribute triangular. Okay, so maybe I will use simply just attribute randomization. It will give us the same result. Here it's color, so I will type P scale. So immediately we see now the sphere become very different. Okay, this is one dimension, not three dimension, and it's a set value. Okay, no problem. So its size, I don't want anything to be zero, so it will be maybe from 0.5, very small, or maybe one something small. This is still very big, so I'll make it zero 0.5. Yeah, something very small, or 0.1 maybe. Yeah, maybe something like this, becoming very very small. Okay, this is first. Or of course you can simply add attribute triangular, type attribute triangular, add p scale equal fit 0.1 dash, or not dash, open bracket, rand, add ptnum, then min max, blah blah blah. But it's easier to just simply add attribute rand. It will make the, we'll type the code for you. Okay, so now let's emit the by the smoke trail. And that was it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any question, please type it below the video. Also, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends. And if you like to support us, you will find below a video a link on Patreon and Gumroad for support. So thank you, and I see you in the next lesson. Have a good day.